Hi, in this video we are going to discuss about hierarchical clustering algorithms. So recall two properties of k-means clustering. What it says, it fits exactly k clusters as user specifies how many number of clusters. K is equal to 2, there are 2 clusters. So based on this number of clusters, the data points are assigned to those clusters in k-means. But that is not the case in hierarchical clustering. Given pairwise dissimilarities, that is dij between data points, hierarchical clustering produces a consistent result without the need to choose initial starting positions. Like number of clusters not need to be mentioned. Initially all the data points are the clusters. Then at the end, it may be into one cluster. Like, we need to choose a way to measure the dissimilarity between groups called the linkage. So, given the linkage, hierarchical clustering produces a sequence of clustering assignments. At one end, all points are in their own cluster. At the other end, all points are in only one cluster. So there are two types of clustering algorithm, agglomerative and divergent. Agglomerative, it is bottom-up approach, starts with all points in their own group. Say we have 5 clusters initially, until there is only one cluster, all the 5 are merged into only one cluster, that is bottom-up approach. Divergent, it's vice versa of, which is top down. Start from all points in one cluster until all points are in their own clusters. Repeatedly split the group into two, resulting in the big dissimilarity. So if you see the agglomerative approach, initially each object is a cluster. You can see there is bottom up approach. Each object is a cluster. In iteration, merge two clusters which are most similar to each other, until all objects are merged into a single cluster. In divergent approach, all objects say in one cluster. In iteration, select a cluster and split into two subclusters until each leaf cluster contains only one object. That is top down. So starting from say A, B, C, D, E in this example, and finally you reach up to only one object. And vice versa happens in agglomerative. So how do I pictorically represent this hierarchical clustering? Is using dendrogram. So dendrogram, which is used to represent pictorically, where it's easily understandable. So like you draw a tree that shows how clusters are merged or split hierarchically. Each node on the tree is a cluster. Each leaf node is a singleton cluster. You can notice, say there are 9 individual clusters, objects, how this is merged into a cluster. Again, how this is merged into a singleton, that is how it is finally merged into a complete cluster. And how do I do split it again? How do I do merge it? And each and every level, by cutting the dendrogram at the desired level, then each connected component forms the cluster. So as I say, agglomerative clustering algorithm, it's a most straightforward and most popular hierarchical clustering technique. So basic algorithm goes like this. Compute distance matrix. Say we have 5 data points. So P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, and compute distance matrix with each other. That is what we called as distance matrix. Let each data point be a cluster initially. Repeat until only a single cluster remains. So merge, compute the distance matrix, take the smallest one, merge the smallest distance, merge these two clusters, then again find out the distance between new cluster with other data points. Again, update the distance matrix. Again, so repeat these steps until only a single cluster remains at the end. So this is the starting situation. How do I do compute the distance matrix? Say we have the 12 small circles, all the small data, that is, all these are the data points, and you compute the distance matrix like a P1, distance between P1, 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 P2, P1, P3, P1, P4, P1, P5 or P1, P5. So all these distance is computed, and this is intermediate situations. So once the cluster is formed, right? So once the distance matrix is computed, find the minimum distance among all the values that is merged into a single cluster, that is cluster 1, cluster 2, cluster 3. So again the values are to be updated, because the distance need to be computed from cluster 1, cluster 2, cluster 3, cluster 4, cluster 5, so on. So this is updated distance matrix. Then again you go for another updation, that is after merging the number of clusters, right? Once the cluster is merged, like cluster C2 and C5 is here merged, so both will be C2 and C5 will be merged. All these values need to be merged with the updations. So how do we represent the hierarchical clustering? So there are three ways you can represent it. One is minimum or single link. So minimum or single link says the distance between two clusters is represented by the distance of the closest pair of data objects, that is minimum distance belonging to the clusters. So like distance between these pair of points, I use minimum of distance between P and Q. So I find out distance between P and Q, the point, say for example x1 x2 and Q is x2 y2. So distance between x1 minus x2 and x2 minus x2. So what is the minimum value? So that must be obtained. So like here it shows how the nested clusters are, right? So initially 3, 6 are into one cluster, and 5, 2 are into another cluster, second cluster, and both are merged into third cluster, and 4 is merged into a fourth cluster, and finally 1 is merged as a fifth cluster. So it forms the nested clusters, and finally there is only one larger cluster, that is 5. So here you can see how it is represented pictorically using dendrogram, and this is strength, because it can handle non-elliptical shapes. And limitations, it may be sensitive to noises and outliers. So noises depends upon the value of the data point, and outliers is the farthest data point. How do I do manage this? And similarly, maximum, the second way of representation is maximum or complete link. So here we need to compute the farthest pair of data points. So I obtain the maximum value, compute distance between P and Q, then I go for obtain the maximum value, and based on this I go for updations in my distance matrix. So how it shows the dendrogram and nested clusters. And the strength is less susceptible to noise and outliers. And third representation is average link. So here I will be finding out distance between P and Q, and I calculate average of these two data points, that is these two distance value. So I sum up these two value divided by 2, I will be getting the average. So that based on those values, I will be updating my distance matrix table. So how it shows the dendrogram, that is a dendrogram, and the nested clusters. So the strength of the complete and average is less susceptible to noise and outliers, and limitations here is biased towards globular clusters. And what about the time and space requirements? So order of n square space, since it uses the distance matrix, right? Say we have the 5 data points, so 5 into 5, that is n square, n is equal to 5, so order of n square, n is number of points. And about the time, order of n cube, so there are n steps, and each step the size is n square, distance matrix must be updated and searched. So the complexity still can be reduced to order of n square log n time for some approaches, but it takes order of n cube in many cases. And strength, as I said, do not have to assume about the number of clusters initially. There is no need to worry about the number of clusters, and there may be correspond to meaningful taxonomies, because hierarchical clustering, it's mostly used, right? Like in shopping websites, if you take the electronic goods items, so they can be appliances, home appliances. Among the home appliances, there may be a TV, fridge, washing machine, AC, and so on. And about the electronic gadgets, there may be PDAs and robot or mobile phones and so on. So you can cluster to these number of groups. Again, each and every electronic devices can be clustered into based on the company, and based on the configuration, based on the model, and so on. So it forms into number of clusters. So problem is, as I said, it may be sensitive to noise and outliers, and may be difficult in handling different sized clusters and irregular shapes, and breaking larger clusters. So these are, again, once you merge two clusters, it again you cannot be undone. So no objective function is directly minimized here. So these are few limitations here, as each and every algorithm has its own advantages and disadvantages. So we'll see hierarchical agglomerative clustering example using single link. So here you can see this is the data points. So we have some 6 data points of item set, that is x and y, and in x and y, how this is plotted, all these 6 data points. Now you need to calculate Euclidean distance for creating the distance matrix. So what we have to do is, we need to calculate distance between P1, P2, P1, 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 P2, P1, P3, P1, P4, P1, P5, P1, P6, distance between. And similarly, P1, P2, P3, P3, P4, sorry, P2, P3, P2, P4, P5, P6. So likewise, all data points distance should be calculated. So I use Euclidean distance for equation here. I compute distance between P1, I get 0, like P1, P2, the data points, right? I take that data points, I compute the distance using distance equation. So like this, I get the distance matrix, like a distance between P2, P3, I'll be adding this. This is P1, P3. So this other part is remains empty, because the values are going to be same, like P2, P2. Now, if I compute P2, P3, the values computed for P2, P3 is 0.15. Sorry, 0.15. So that value will be same here. So I just leave this cells are empty, right? So I hope this is understandable, right? So now, once the distance between all the data points is computed, I see which value is minimum value, that is 0.11. This is the minimum value. The circled one is minimum value. So now I need to merge P3 and P6, because this is minimum value. Now I need to merge these two data points into one cluster, P3 and P6. So now, once this is decided, right, P3, P6 need to be merged. Now I need to compute distance between, because I want to update the distance matrix. So I need to compute distance between P3, P6 to P1, and P3, P6 to P2, and P3, P6 to P4, P3, P6 to P5. That is the newly formed cluster with all other data points. So here you can notice. So here, again using the equation minimum. So minimum of distance between P3, P3, P6 to P1. So distance between P3, P1 and P6, P1. So what are the values? So P3, P1 is 0.22 and P6, P1 is 0.22. What is minimum value? 0.22. So like this, I need to compute distance between, so this is how I dendrogram representation. That is, both are merged into one cluster, P3, P6. Now, distance between P3, P6 with P1 is computed. Similarly, P2 is computed. Similarly, P4 is computed, then P5 is computed. Now, all these values are need to be updated. So, see the updated distance matrix. So, all these values are, so these four values we computed, right? These four values we computed. All these values are updated and remaining values remain same. Now again see which value is minimum value within this distance matrix table, 0.14. Now what is the thing is, we need to merge P2 and P5. So we merge P2 and P5. So both are merged. Now what we have to do is, now we have to compute distance between P2, P5 with this cluster, and what are the other data points we need to compute? P1 and P4. So distance between P2, P5 with P1. So distance between P2, P1 and P5, P1. So I'll be getting 0.23. So again minimum is obtained. What is the distance between P2, P1? 0.23. What is the distance between P5 and P 0.34? What is the minimum value? 0.23. So similarly, I compute distance between this new cluster with this old cluster with the P1 and P4. So with this, I'll be getting these values. Now update the distance matrix with these values. So now update the now P2 and P5 is merged. Now these three values I computed, right? These three values I computed, right? 0.22, 0.15, and 0.20. Is updated. These three values I updated. Fine. So once updation is done, again look for the minimum value. So 0.15. Now merge these two into one cluster. Now again we need to find the distance between, this is new cluster, right? So I want to merge this. So this new cluster with, what are the other data points, remaining data points? P1 and P4. Now distance between this new cluster with the P1, minimum is obtained, and distance between this new cluster with the P4, because only there are two data points remains. So what is the, so update this, update the distance matrix. If I merge, after merging this into this table, I'll be updating these two values, that is 0.22 with 0.55. So this is updated, this is updated. Once this is done, so look for minimum value, that is 0.15. Then again update P4 with P2, P5, P3, P6. New cluster is formed. Now again distance matrix need to be updated. So distance between the new cluster is this. So this with, what are the other data point? Only P1 is remaining. So now P1 need to be computed. So now what is the new cluster with P1 I need to compute. So now if I go with P1, so again I need to compute the new cluster with the P1, that is that's P2, P5, P3, P6 with 4, and similarly with P1. So this minimum distance is obtained, that is 0.22. So with P1 and with P4. So once this distance is computed, the minimum is obtained, 0.22. Now you can see the distance matrix is updated, right? Distance matrix is updated after merging these two values. The distance matrix is updated. So 0.22, there is only value, that is 0.22. Now merge the remaining clusters, that is P1, because there is only one value. So P1 with these clusters merged. So finally this merge all the data points, the initial clusters, individual clusters are merged into a complete cluster. Now again the second way of representation is using complete link. Again it is very similar. The only difference you have to note it down is the same way how we performed in single link. But here I need to get the maximum value. In distance matrix we need to look for minimum value, right, and merge these two. And here I need to compute using equation maximum of distance between two data points, that is a new cluster with the other data points, right? So maximum is obtained here. Instead of, so in a single link we used minimum, right? All other everything is same, remains same, but only thing is here I need to use maximum. So maximum should be obtained, right? So same way I update the distance matrix, look for minimum, I merge again, find out the maximums, update the distance matrix again, merge, I mean look for minimum, merge the cluster again, find the maximum and update the distance matrix again, I merge, look for minimum, merge and find the maximum, then again update the distance matrix, merge the into complete cluster by looking for the minimum, because here it is only one value, I merge these two into a complete cluster. And similarly for average link, the third way of representation, we use this equation, so that is average. So now distance between two data points is computed and add these two distance divided by 2, I will be getting average. So that value will be used for similarly obtain average for all the data points distance between data points, then using those values go for updating the distance matrix, then look for minimum and repeat the same until you find the final complete cluster. I hope this video it makes you very clear and in understanding hierarchical clustering algorithm. And if anything else, please do comment. Thank you.